So let's talk about discs. Disc bulges, disc herniations, disc prolapses. There's so much confusion amongst the public about what all these different terminologies mean, what they are. All you know is they cause an extraordinary amount of pain. So I'm going to help you, give you a little bit of clarity, help you understand the differences and what you can do to sort it out. So for this purpose, I'm going to need my dear friend here. Now, as you know, your spine is not just a pile of bones stuck together. You've got this, all your vertebrae here, that's the bones, they're called vertebrae. Excuse me, I'm assuming zero knowledge, so if you already know this, I apologize. In between all your vertebrae are the discs. Now the discs are essentially sponges and they allow your spine to move. So this is the front, this is the back. When you bend forward, your discs will move backwards. When you move backwards, your discs will move forwards, and vice versa. When you go sideways, the discs basically essentially move to allow movement in your spine. It's not difficult, it's not complicated. They're extraordinary things. Without these, you would you'd be walking around like a tin man, and that would not be very good. So what happens to discs? What is a disc injury? What is a bulge? What is a herniation? And what is a prolapse? Okay, so a disc is like a donut. If you were to look at it from a bird's eye view, if I were to pull one of these discs out here, sit it here like this, and you could look it down, it's like a donut. In the middle, it's got a ball of jam. It's not jam, it's kind of gel. And around it is fibrous. Now, when you lift something heavy awkwardly, or when you sit a lot, when you fly a lot, there's a lot of things that can happen that essentially cause tiny little tears to happen in the fibrous part. And over many, many years, those tears get deeper and deeper. And eventually, that jelly begins to move out through the tears and pushes on the surface of the disc, causing the disc to bulge. Now, this is what we call a herniation. A bulge and herniation is the same thing. It's just a tear in the disc. The surface of the disc is not breached, but the jelly is pushing out. Now, outside of your spine run your nerves, your spinal nerves. And the bottom five obviously supply your legs. Okay, L1 to 5 and also the sacral nerves supply your legs. If your disc bulges, a disc can bulge any direction, forward, backwards, right, left. A disc can actually bulge and completely miss a nerve, in which case you would experience no pain whatsoever. You might experience a back spasm, but you wouldn't experience any pain in your legs. If, however, you're one of the unlucky ones, and many of you watching this are, the disc can bulge and hit one of your spinal nerves, supplying, if it's in the lumbar spine, supplying your legs. In that situation, depending which level your disc has bulged, it will send agonizing pain, either down the front of your leg, the side, the back, or the inside, just depending which level has been hit. So one of the first signs of a disc bulge is pain in the sole of your foot because you've hit the S1 nerve. Disc bulges can also happen in your neck, in which case you would get pain in your hand and in your arm. It can happen at any level of the spine. Now, what then is a prolapse? Prolapse is when the bulge comes out and it actually bulges so much that the surface of the disc is breached, it's torn, and that jelly comes out of the disc and surrounds the spinal nerve completely. It's basically the disc is completely broken. So if you just have a bulge, as you can imagine, you can get a pain-free position because you, as long as you can get yourself into a position where you can take that disc off the nerve, if your disc is bulging this way, if you bend this way, you might find your leg pain completely goes away. But if you have a prolapse, you will not be able to get a pain-free position. People who have prolapses end up pretty much on morphine, whereas people who have just disc bulges, herniations, can get away with a bit of cocodamol, anti-inflammatories, and painkillers. Now, there is absolutely masses that you can do to help the recovery of a disc bulge, a or a disc herniation and a prolapse. But it's really, really important that you get the correct advice. Now, in my next few videos, that is what we're going to be looking at, what you should do. How do you look after a disc herniation? How do you look after a prolapse? How do you get yourself out of pain? Now, those of you who have experienced either of these conditions will be well aware of quite how painful it is. It's been described to me that it's as painful as giving birth, if not worse. And I truly believe that. There is nothing like seeing someone, the pain level someone is in with a disc injury. So one of the other symptoms of a disc injury will be a massive spasm of the muscles around the back, and they're doing that to stabilize your back. So there's a masses, and I mean masses, that you can do to balance your muscles in your back to protect the disc. So how do you look after an injured disc? How do you recover an injured disc? And what do you do to prevent it happening again? Watch my next few videos and find out.